Now we have already entered the data. Let us understand how to use it. On your screen, you can see icon Analyze. In the earlier versions, in place of Analyze, Statistics word was there. And you know that most of the people, they are afraid of statistics. So they are afraid of the word statistics. Now, the Analyze word is a general word, whereas statistics is not a general word. So they have, in place of statistics, have used Analyze. Now you can click on Analyze. You will get a drop down box. In the drop down box, the second icon is descriptive statistics. This we have to use in order to find out whether we have made some mistakes in entering the data. Normally, I will advise that before you start analyzing your data, after having entered the data in the SPSS, you must compare it with your original data and make sure that you have entered the data correctly. If it is not, it will be reflected in your output. So make sure data entered are correct. Now, if suppose I go to the descriptive statistics, as soon as I click here, another dialog box, another drop-down box comes, and the first is the frequencies. If I click on the frequency, I get a dialog box in which on the right hand side it's a blank. So if I want to know whether I have entered the information of gender correctly or not, then I can shift from left hand side dialog box to the right hand side, on the right hand side where variable or variables is written. So I can click it, and if I want to shift it back on the left hand side dialog box, I can do that. Make sure this only can help you to find out your mistakes only if the variable is a discontinuous variable. If it is a continuous variable, then this cannot help you to find out your own mistakes. That is why I request you that after entering the data, you must compare it with your original data and make corrections if need be. Now, let us see how do we do it. Say, types of school, also I shift on this. Say, residential background, I also shift because all these are discontinuous variables. Now, I can click on OK. Then on your screen, you will get a output and the title is frequencies. Now here, first title is statistics. Here written N, valid. That means how much data you have entered. It is of 62 people. N is 62. So there are the 62 cases. Now if you see the first one where you can see the males are 33 and females are 28 and there is one more 3. That means this 3 is wrong information is entered as far as the gender is concerned. So we should go back to our original sheet and go to the column where we have written gender and we scroll it down till we come across the three. And once we do that, then we should see in the original sheet and try to find out whether in place of three, should I type one or two. It all depends upon whether it is a male or a female. Let us scroll it down and we see that in case of government schools, aided schools and private schools, in types of school, there is absolutely no mistakes as far as our codes are concerned. In the rural and urban area also, it's perfectly all right. But understand that in the first one also, if you see missing, it shows one. And in the other one also, it shows one. That means there must be one particular row in which we have not entered the data. And we have to find out that one and then we have to cut that. Otherwise, your data will be read as 63 in place of 62. So, let us go back to our sheet. I can minimize it, go to the sheet and find out where is 3. In under gender column, serial number 51, the 3 has been entered. So I can check it with my original and I will find this is has to be female. So I have entered 2. I scroll it down and I find that this 63 is active. In reality, there is no information. So this 63 should be either you cut or you clear it. If I clear it, now you will find and you can check once again. Let us try and you will find that everything is okay now. Yes. Now you can see that total number is 62. Males are 33, females are 29, government schools are 19, aided schools 23, and private, and nowhere any missing. So please make sure that there are no missing terms. Now, once you have verified that the data which are entered, they are correct. Now we proceed for analysis. I will demonstrate you few of the statistical techniques. Say, if I want to analyze my data using t-test, so let us see how do we proceed. For t-test, click on analyze. From this drop-down box, nowhere it is written t-test. So as a researcher, I must know that t-test only helps a researcher to compare the means. So if you see on this dialog box, at the serial number 3, compare means is written. So I can bring my cursor at the compare means. And the moment I bring the cursor here, another drop-down box is there. And in this, if you see that the t-test here is independent samples t-test. I have already told you that as a researcher, you must know different names of statistics. So t-test has two different names. One is independent samples t-test, another is students t-test. So if I want to use independent sample t-test, so I should go to independent sample t-test, bring the cursor here and click. Now before clicking, please make sure, see, on the right-hand side, small t is written. But, I'm sorry, on the left-hand side, small t is written. On the right-hand side, it is a capital T. T-test cannot be designated with capital T. It is always with small t. So, you will find that you cannot copy-paste your output. So, let us click on the independent samples t-test. Once you do that, you get a dialog box on which it is written test variables. Suppose I am interested in comparing the achievement. So, I can select achievement and shift it on my right-hand side dialog box. Next is, say, intelligence. I can select and shift it to the right-hand side dialog box. If there are other variables whose means you want to compare, you can shift all them on the right-hand side dialog box. Now, I know that t-test can be used only to compare the mean scores of two groups. So, here gender has got two groups. So, I click gender and then I shift it to groups value. So, grouping value is there. Now, once you bring the gender in it, immediately in the bracket there will be two question marks and the defined group will be active. Now, you click on the defined groups, you get a new dialog box where group 1 and group 2 is written. Since males, I have designated to be 1 and 2. So, I can enter 1 in group 1 and I can enter 2 in group 2. As soon as I enter 2, immediately continue icon will be active. Let me tell you, whether you compare male with female or female with male, the result will not differ. It will be the same. So, if you are interested, you may check it yourself first by putting against group 1-1 and against group 2-2, analyze it. Now, you reverse that against group 1, you can enter 2 and against group 2, you enter 1 and do the analysis yourself and you will find both results are same. Now, you continue. Now, you find on the right-hand side, top, there is an option button. Click here. Here, you will find that confidence interval is written. I am sure you know that confidence interval is another name of level of significance. Only difference is, if it is confidence interval, it is expressed in percentages. If it is a level of significance, then it is not expressed in percentages. So, by default, it will always be confidence interval will be 95%. If you want to change, you can change. There is absolutely no problem. But by default, it will always be 95% or level of significance will be 0.05. So, anytime you like to make a change in the confidence interval, you can do it. If you want to change level of significance, wherever it comes, you can do that. Suppose I don't change, I proceed further. So, I click on the continue. Now, I click on OK. Now, you get on your screen, the output. Now you can see there is a capital T, T test. This is wrong. This should not be capital. This should be small. So therefore, you get the two tables. On one table, group statistics is written. On another table, independent samples t-test is written. Now from these two tables, you have to make another table which you will use in order to test your hypothesis and in order to answer the question which you have written in the form of objectives. So the choice now is yours. So I will presume that now you can analyze your data using SPSS with the help of the t-test. Now let us proceed. Suppose I want to analyze the data with the help of one-way ANOVA. How do we do? Click on Analyze, go to Compare Means, and in that, on the right hand side, the dialog box, you can see in the bottom it is written one way analysis of variance. So I can bring the cursor at the one way analysis of variance and I click it here. Now here there is a dialog box where dependent list is written. Please understand, these words are just, they have written as a general words. These are not very technical words. But you should understand that under dependent list, only that variable is to be shifted, whose means you want to compare. And you already know that one way ANOVA should be used when you have a variable which has at least three labels. But if there is a variable with two labels and if you still use one-way ANOVA, or with two labels if you use t-test, both results will be the same. If you want to verify, well, you can verify. Let us try. So dependent list, here I am shifting achievement in science because I want to compare the means here. Now on the right hand side, another lower one, you have factor. If I shift gender here, so I select gender and I shift it here. You have already analyzed your data with the help of t-test by taking gender. So let us take gender and see, do we get a different result or not. Now on your right hand side, the bottom icon is options. Let us click on the options. As soon as we click, the first icon is descriptives. Second is fixed and random effects. Third is homogeneity of variance test. Fourth, Brown-Forshee. Like this, there are many options. So as a researcher, I must know which one I need. Because if you click on all, the SPSS will give you the output for all. But from these outputs, which one to use will be the decision of the researcher. SPSS cannot help. So suppose I need mean, standard deviation, etc. So I can click on descriptives. I say continue. Let us say post hoc. This post hoc here, there are 12 options. Post hoc test should be used only and only if you have a variable with three levels or more than three levels, and if the f value for that variable is significant, and you want to find out which groups of that particular variable differ from another group, then you use this one. Otherwise, there is no need of using. In this particular case, since we have only a variable gender, it has only two levels, so there is no need of using any other statistics here. So I say continue. So post hoc test cannot be used. If we go to the top icon, here you will find lot of things are there. And if you do not understand, you may click on help. And sometime the help will really help you, and sometime I don't know whether you will be helped or you will be confused after reading the help. Now this exactly is to be used if you want to see the trend. Since in this case we do not have data for the trend, so I'll just cancel it and I'll say OK. Here written one way. Now here it is not written one way ANOVA. So therefore you know that you have clicked on one way ANOVA. So whatever is given under one way, then it's all related to one way ANOVA. In this one way, you know the first table, the heading is descriptives. And in this you can see that achievement in science is written at the top of this particular table. And here it is males and females and total and mean, standard deviation, standard error, etc., etc., etc. Lot of information is given. Now, which information you want to use, that has to be decided by you. If you go to the below it, there is a table and above it is written ANOVA. Please see, here it is not written one way ANOVA, it is only written ANOVA. But you know, you have done one way ANOVA, so it is one way ANOVA. In this particular table, you know, in the first column, between groups is there, within groups is there, total is there, second is sum of squares is there, third is DF, degree of freedom, fourth is mean square is there, then F value is there. Now you can see the relationship between this F value and the T value. For your information, if you take the square root of this F value, which is 0.302, if you take the square root of 0.302, then you will get the value which will be 0.550. Therefore, that means if you take the square root of f, its value will be equal to t. If you square the t, its value will be equal to f. That means sometime you can use SPSS to explain some of the basic concepts. And this is how now you can analyze your data with the help of t-test and as well as with the help of one-way ANOVA. Let us proceed further and take another example and see how do we analyze our data with the help of one-way ANOVA. Let us go to analyze. That's right. Where do we go now? Okay. Because we have to compare means, so we go to compare means. Then on the right-hand side, the dialog box, we go to the bottom of it, where capital F is on the left-hand side, and on the right-hand side, one-way ANOVA is written. I click on it, I get a dialog box. I have already entered some of the variables, some information, because just now I analyzed. Now, if I want to reuse it, I can say reset. So therefore, on your right-hand side, all the dialog box, they don't have any value. Now, if I want to compare the achievements, so I select achievement and shift it to the dependent list. Since I want to compare the achievement of students belonging to the three different schools, so I take types of school, I select, I shift it to the factor. Now, at present, no variable is in the factor, so you can see that OK icon is not active and paste icon is not active. So therefore, they will become active only once you shift that some variable here. Since I will be comparing the mean scores of achievement in science of students studying in government schools, aided schools, and private schools, so types of school I will shift here. Let me shift. As soon as I shifted, OK becomes active and paste also becomes active. All right. Now we go to the options. Since we want mean, so we can click against the descriptives. So descriptive become active. I say continue. Now in this case, because there are three types of scores, so I can even do post hoc test. But please understand, from the 12 different post hoc tests, you must know which one to use. It is not if you click on all, SPSS is going to give you the output. But whether that output is of some use or that output becomes a garbage, that depends upon you as a researcher. So I know it that I can compare the means by using a test whose name is Duncan's Multiple Range Test. Now here it is, only Duncan is written. Please understand. So you as a researcher must know complete name of the Duncan. Otherwise you will not be able to decide whether Duncan is to be used or not. You can use LSD also. You can click on LSD. And you can see it yourself that both results will be the same. So either you can use the output of LSD for interpretation purpose, or you can use the output of Duncan's for interpretation purpose. You need not to use the output of LSD as well as Duncan's, because both will give you the same result. So there is no sense of using. So, if you decide only to use one, then you need not to click on both. But for understanding purpose, you can click, no problem at all. Because outputs you need not to use. Now, here you can see significance level is there. And by default, it is 0.05. I did not tell you, but I presumed that you know it. That in social sciences, the maximum allowed error is 5%. In social sciences, it is okay. But in pure sciences, 5% error is quite high error. There you may like to have error lesser than the 5%. But in social sciences, we have 5% because it is very difficult to have rigid controls. So you should read and understand the levels of significance and how exactly the errors can be minimized by you. And there are different ways to minimize the error. I need not to tell you at this particular point. So I click on continue. Now next is the contrast, which I have already explained. In this case, you are not going to see the trend, so there is no need. And now I click on OK. So you get the output of the SPSS. It is written one way, then one table on that it is written descriptive, the second table written ANOVA, the third table written post hoc test. Now these outputs contain lot of other information. So as a researcher, you really have to decide which information to use and which one not to use. So this is how you can analyze the data using SPSS and t-test. So SPSS for the t-test and SPSS for the one-way ANOVA. Next, we'll do in the next session. Thank you very much.